Good morning. This year marks the 75th anniversary of the end of World War II. 2.5 weeks ago, VE Day, or Victory in Europe Day, was remembered. On March 7, 1945, one of the vilest regimes in history was destroyed. On that day, Nazi Germany surrendered to the Western Allies and their associate power, the Soviet Union. Because of the global health panic, there were only small memorial services to mark the occasion. The first surrender date did not receive the attention it was due, and the second may not either. In 3 months, the other significant historical date will be remembered when, after two of the most powerful weapons in the world had been used against them, another totalitarian empire was defeated. VJ Day, or Victory Over Japan, occurred when the Empire of Japan surrendered on August 15, 1945, bringing an end to the greatest conflict the world had ever seen. The final official surrender of Japan was on September 2, 1945. Over 20 million people died during World War II. Over 400,000 American military men and women paid the ultimate price for our victory. Many more would have died if not for the advances in medical treatment and the actions of doctors, nurses, and especially the frontline medics, men like Desmond Doss. If you've seen the movie Hacksaw Ridge, you've seen the Hollywood version of his story. While containing many of the basic facts of his life, to make the story flow and seem more interesting, some of the times, places, and actions were changed, added, or removed, some because they were just too incredible. This does not, however, change what he did. The true story of his actions he took while earning the Medal of Honor are incredible, and earn it he did. His concern and dedication to the lives of other men serving with him is one of the hallmarks of a Medal of Honor recipient. Desmond Doss was a Seventh-day Adventist and a conscientious objector. He could have requested some other non-military type war work, but he felt it was his duty to serve. Most medics experience some derision and abuse during training, but it's usually good-natured. But when the bullets start to fly, they become a valuable and respected member of their team. But because of his religious beliefs and his status, Doss endured far worse ridicule, harassment, and abuse, similar to what is shown in the movie. But he never wavered in his beliefs. He kept going by reading the small pocket Bible his wife had given him for comfort and direction. After basic training, the men of the 307th Infantry Regiment, 77th Division, went to the Pacific to fight. They first saw action during the liberation of Guam in July of 1944, then fought on Leyte, Philippine Islands, in November of 1944. During these actions, Doss showed his bravery by receiving 2 Bronze Stars with V for Valor emblems, which are only awarded for combat actions. He received 1 for Guam and 1 for Leyte. On March 26, 1944, the regiment assaulted Yakiba Shima of the Okinawa Island Group, and from late April until June 1945, they fought on Okinawa proper. Desmond Doss Medal of Honor citation explains what he did to receive the highest American award for bravery as follows. On May 1, he was company aid man to the 1st Battalion when they assaulted a jagged escarpment 400 feet high. As the U.S. troops gained the summit, a heavy concentration of enemy fire crashed into them, inflicting approximately 75 casualties and driving the others back. Private First Class Doss refused to seek cover and remained in the fire-swept area with the many wounded, carrying them one by one to the edge of the escarpment and there lowering them down on a rope-supported litter, the face of a cliff, to friendly hands. On May 2nd, he exposed himself to heavy rifle and mortar fire to rescue a wounded man 200 yards forward of the lines on the same escarpment. On May 4th, he treated 4 men who had been shot down while assaulting a strongly defended cave, and he advanced through a shower of grenades to within 8 yards of enemy forces where he dressed his comrade wounds before making 4 trips under fire to carry them to safety. On May 5th, he unhesitatingly braved enemy shelling and small arms fire to assist a wounded soldier, where he applied bandages, moved the man to a spot that was protected from small arms fire, and while artillery and mortar shells fell close by, he administered plasma. Later on that same day, an American was severely wounded by enemy fire from a cave, and Private First Class Doss crawled to him, where he was fallen 25 feet from an enemy position. Private First Class Doss administered aid and then carried him 100 yards to safety, continually exposed to enemy fire. On the 21st of May, in a night attack, he remained in exposed territory, helping the wounded while fearlessly risking the chance that he would be mistaken for an infiltrating Japanese. He gave aid to the wounded until he himself was seriously injured in the legs by the explosion of a grenade. Rather than call another aid man from cover, he cared for his own injuries and waited for 5 hours before litter bearers could reach him and start carrying him to cover. The trio was caught in an enemy attack, and Private First Class Doss, seeing a more critically wounded man nearby, crawled off the litter and directed the litter bearers to give that man aid first. While he waited for them to return, he was shot again, this time suffering a compound fracture of his arm. With magnificent fortitude, he bound the rifle stock to his shattered arm as a splint and then crawled over 300 yards of rough terrain to the aid station. Through his outstanding bravery and unflinching determination in the face of desperately dangerous conditions, Private First Class Doss saved the lives of many soldiers. His name became a symbol throughout the 77th Infantry Division for outstanding gallantry far above and beyond the call of duty. While rescuing the men from Hacksaw Ridge, each time he got one of them to safety, he prayed, "Please God, let me get just one more." Later, even though wounded himself, he continued treating wounded soldiers and then gave up his place to another for rescue. He was one of 11 medics to receive the Medal of Honor in World War II and the only conscientious objector to receive this high honor until Vietnam. So what does all this have to do with communion? First, as men and women died to free the world from tyranny, Jesus sacrificed himself to free us from tyranny. He died to free us from sin and to claim final, total triumph over Satan and death. And just as there's no easy road to victory in a war, there was no easy road for Jesus' victory. But he came to do what he had to do. As it says in Romans, God demonstrates his own love for us in this. While we were still sinners, Christ died for us. While Desmond Doss did not have to pay the ultimate cost serving his country in World War II, over 2,200 men and women of the medical corps did pay that cost. As it says in 1 John 3:16, this is how we know what love is. Jesus Christ laid down his life for us, and we ought to lay down our lives for our brothers. And as Christ died for us, we must be prepared to die for others, especially our brother and sister Christians. Second, we must remain on mission. Desmond Doss did not let fear or injuries keep him from helping wounded soldiers. His prayer was, for just one more. We must have that same dedication to the mission Jesus gave us. As Christians, we're called to bring as many others with us to Jesus. He gave us the mission to preach the gospel of the good news of salvation to the entire world. We're involved in this whether we like it or not. If we're called Christian, then our role must be an active one because we're on the front line every day. This weekend, we honor the memory of men and women that died to help us free the world. However, at this time in our service, we remember the ultimate victory we have through Jesus' death and resurrection. Our Savior won the victory for us, even though we don't deserve it. Communion and the cross remind us so we never forget the price that Jesus had to pay because of his great love for us. Join with me in prayer. Heavenly Father, we thank you so much for the love that Jesus showed us on the cross. We ask that you never, never let us forget. Help us take that message out to the world. And as Desmond Doss said, help us to get just one more. You love everyone and you want all to be part of your kingdom. And use us to make that come true. And we ask this all in Jesus' name. Amen.